everybody. Another Friday and another week of golden opportunities spreads out before us. Oh, crikey. Right, it's Friday, so it's vlog time then. We've got a film club at the end of this vlog, which concerns an apple tree. More on that later. My good lady wife is just recovering from COVID. It didn't hit her too badly because we're all jabbed up. Yeah, she's just recovering from COVID. I'm waiting for her to pass it on to me. She's very generous like that. It sounds like someone's going to mow their lawn. Good Lord. All right, anyway. She's not the only one in the wars. I've got a note here from Trev Joyce, who says, currently sitting here nursing a couple of broken ribs in my back after a fall. Ooh, nasty. I once cracked a couple of ribs falling off a motorbike. Not a recommended procedure. And as I recall, it was extremely painful. Worst being, you couldn't take a deep breath. Hurt too much. So, Trev, get better soon. He says, thanks for keeping me entertained, as I'm pretty immobile at the moment. Well, everybody on the Parkinson's Walks family wishes you well. I hope you get better soon. And I hope we get some sort of comfort, Trev. Well done, mate. Hang in there. William Wellbore then. Now we're going into matters arising, which is on the concerns the Malvern Autumn Walk that we did at the end of the last vlog. Seemed to be went down quite well. William Wellbore. Watching the video in bright sunshine marks a stark contrast to the dull, sullen, dark overcast and very wet day here in Melbourne, Australia. Yeah, you've had it pretty grim out there, haven't you, this year apparently. Yeah, so it brightened my day enormously. Well, William, good. Pleased about that. That's what we like to hear. Markham Richardson, he says, a glorious autumn walk which captures the magic of one of my favourite places. Though I've not been south of the Herefordshire Beacon, whatever the weather, the season, I think there's something uplifting about winding one's way up the steep hillsides to a ridge affording panoramic views over a vast area bounded by the Midland Plain, the Cotswolds and the Welsh Hills. Yeah, you're starting to capture it there, aren't you, Markham? Beautiful. It is a lovely place. Michael from Poland. Greetings from Poland. If the music be the food of love, play on. Oh, you old romantic, Michael. Hee hee. Autumn at its very best. A beautiful walk through magnificent countryside. Yeah, a lovely walk, wouldn't it? Railway Christiana, or Christina, sorry. Railway Christina. Our Christina says, lovely violin solo of Nimrod. It fits the landscape. She's not the only one that thought that. Apparently a lot of people were impressed with our Mr. Elgar. And it should be... should work well, shouldn't it really, since he composed a lot of his music round and about the Malverns, round about there. James Weeks. Hi Ron, well that beautiful autumn walk in the Malverns really made me homesick. Homesick. James, you were born in Canada, you live in Canada. Homesick. I don't know if these little midgey things flying around here. Anyway, back to James. Sorry about that, James, sorry for the interruption. He said, and you certainly pulled out the big guns by adding Elgar to the mix. It's cooling down here, which makes Sumac very happy. OVM, official virtual mascot, our Sumac. Morning, Sumac. It makes Sumac very happy not being a fan of the heat. The other day I was pedaling hard and James goes into one of his stories. James has a following on this channel, with quite a few people comment on his ramblings, I have to say. And it's good to see, yeah. But here's another one now, concerning his bike and gearing trouble. Go read it, it'll make you smile, I guarantee it. Good old James. Vintage trains and abandoned railway. The Malverns and Nimrod, excellent. Another wonderful walk with fabulous autumn scenery. And next, there's a point with Darron. He's just launched a film on his channel concerning the Chipping Norton tunnel. And when I did my Cheltenham to Banbury Direct Railway, I filmed the southern portal. I couldn't get to the north, but Ron's found a way through. It's a lovely film, it's a lovely walk, and another one I recommend to you. Go and have a quick squint. Hairy golfer Simon. I was asking how many people had layouts, since we're all sort of interested in railways, and there's bound to be some layouts out there. Well, Simon writes, the table will be constructed in a couple of weeks and then I will get cracking on building the layout. It's now a fraction too dark for going golfing after work. I'm going to play with his training set instead. Get it all out there laid out properly. The YouTube channel will open in January and it's called Engage on a Shelf. That's catchy, isn't it? Yeah, well done. We look forward to seeing that, Simon. I'd like to see lots of train layouts. They're very good. And actually, I don't know whether you search YouTube. Some people, when they get their layouts and they start detailing it, blimey, it's amazing. It's really amazing. Right, David Bellani, our David from talking from Spain. Perfect selection of music and some lovely photography. I didn't want it to end. I was shouting for an encore, but I'll settle for a trip to Barclay next week. He said, most of the forests and woods nearby are pine trees, so we don't see the leaves changing colour over a large expanse. Although if you go to the north, apparently you've got lots and lots of chestnut trees there. Again, if you want to know about the scenery in the area, go and read David's comments, it's brilliant. He says here, maybe it's not possible to keep a wild boar, as Trevor Joyce has suggested. See, Trevor, you might be on the sick list, but you're still getting some stick. Nobody escapes here. He said, a few years ago, we came across a wild pig walking the streets. When we got closer, we could see that it was on a lead and it was being walked. Apparently, people keep them as pets. Wouldn't want that on the end of your bed, would you? Cry. He said, I don't have a layout yet. It's another Simon then, but tinker about with trains, clockwork, Dublo and steam that me and my dad used to run up in the attic. Ah, happy days, happy days. Yeah. He says, when time and space allows, I'll do something more permanent with them. I've put some bits and pieces on my channel. Apologies for the poor quality videos in advance. Yeah, get it in there first. Well done, David. Good move. Lionel and Mary Travers, Lionel says, he put an awful lot of into that walk, yeah. The old uphill and downhill, I'm not sure I could do it now, to be honest, that was filmed a while ago. Now, Lionel, up on his channel, I'm doing a lot of channel stuff this week, Lionel on his channel has just uploaded a film of a ploughing match here in the UK. I've always wanted to go to a ploughing match, never got there yet. But it turns out, we find out from Lionel after that he actually used to do ploughing competitions and he won a couple of them as well. So you can quite understand, can't you? If you watch Lionel's film, you get the proper information in the proper format, so he knows what he's talking about. So that's another one. You're going to have a busy week. That's our traveller. Propped up there, you can go and have a look around all these, Trev. Well done. West Country Wanderings, our Paul, and he's still wandering down the River Severn, doing some magnificent filming. I would say if you're coming to the West Country, it will pay you to go look on Paul's site, wherever you're going, and see whether he's actually filmed it. Chances are he will have done, and then you can enjoy your visit with all the information you need. Anyway, Paul says, I include the whole of the three counties as part of my wider West Country on my channel. And the Malverns are the pinnacle of that wider region. In my humble opinion, yes, I've walked on Cornish beaches, in Devon Coves, sauntered Somerset Moors, embraced Wiltshire Downs, discovered Dorset Doors and Gloucestershire Wolds, and I love them all. But I find nothing better than this quiet and spiritually stirring corner of Worcestershire and Hereford, that is the Malverns. I don't think anybody could say it any better, Paul. It's very true. Andrew Merriman, our Andrew. What a lovely walk. And as always, in Elgar, you found the perfect music to accompany us. It's been over half a century since I walked the Malverns, and they're still as beautiful as ever. Half a century. Where did the years go, Andrew? Crikey me. The old Mike, another glorious video accompanied by wonderful music. I think that may be the best version of Nimrod that I've heard. Yeah, I think it was the London Philharmonic. Very good. We've got some pretty key musicians there. Jim Nichols. thanks for the plug for my channel in your vlog. No worries, Jim. But you should have made it clear that it's not compulsory to watch all 1,905 videos. 1,905 videos. My gosh, that's dedication, isn't it? If you can't find something that you like amongst that lot, there's nothing going to please you, I don't think. Well done. He says, I'm still laughing at the thought of you in a tracker wild boar seeking out artifacts on your next exploration. Yes, that's Trevor again. Pete Payne. He says, a lovely film of a lovely area. You didn't find a rather large rusty sunbeam bicycle laying in the bushes, grown by the name of Mr. Phoebus, did you? He said, that reminds me of being at the Veterans Cycle Weekend at Badminton Village Hall. And then Pete goes and tells a lovely story concerning the vicar. Another one. Go and have a read of that one. That's well worth a look. I wish I could read them all out here, but we'd just sit here all day just reading them out, wouldn't we? You guys can do that. Right, the film last week then. Barclay Station site. They're just digging it out of the ground and hope to get it back up and running again. Andrew says, what a wonderful piece of detective work you did to find so much of what was once an extensive railway site. Tony S. has outlined today's operations of the site in much better detail than I ever could, so I will concentrate on what was once there. And Andrew does what Andrew does, and he explains all the layout, everything you need to know about what was there, is there, and how it all worked as well. Brilliant. Brilliant, Andrew. His reference there to Tony S., comes because Tony's commented under the channel name of DH Dove, and Tony says, hi Ron, great to see you made it to Barclay. The CEGB, Central Electricity Generating Board site, is still active despite the closure of both Barclay and Oldbury power stations. DRS runs double headed class 68s there, occasionally a 68 and an 88. And then Tony goes on to describe the actual traffic movements and the operation there. It's wonderful, wonderful. Thank you, Tony, stepping in there. That's good of you. And Tony actually has fielded a few questions as well, which is outstanding. Now, that can't be Trevor up there. Hey, noisy is the devil. Can't blame you for that one, Trev. Two of them. Ah, that might explain it then. Right. I'll just give them another 10 seconds to clear out the way. Good. Near enough. Jim Nichols. Ah, Jim's back again then. He's 82 by the way last week. The site of the railway station looked like an archaeological dig, and I was expecting Tony Robertson to pop up any minute. For those of you not in the know, Tony Robertson was a presenter of an archaeological program on television. He brought archaeology to the masses, and it was a good program. I used to enjoy watching those. Anyway, no, Tony wasn't there, Jim. Instead, all we got was a guy in a funny hat. Leave my hat out of this. I said to Jim, I hope the birthday party went well. And I was rather hoping he'd sent us all a virtual slice of birthday cake. But Jim replied, sorry Ron, I ate virtually all of it. You would. Rodney Masters. Rodney Masters. Your staggeringly knowledgeable viewers typically fleshed out some of the fascinating extra detail. Yeah? Go into the comments and have a read round there, and it's amazing what you'll find out. They can maybe answer my question as to whether the Hinckley B waste via Bridgewater is also taken to the site. If so, will Hinckley C also be part of the same plan? And Tony stepped in and answered all that. Amazing. That all the current nuclear power stations we got round and about this country. Amazing. Yeah, so Tony, thank you once again. David Bellani. He says, hi Ron, hope you didn't get back glowing red. Only at night. He said, I think you need to go with a hat, sun cream and a Geiger counter. That would have been useful. One answer to the bridge viaduct conundrum might be. This debate's been rolling around in Parkinson's Walk for, must be years now. When does a bridge become a viaduct? Now, to me, I think more than three arches and you've got yourself a viaduct. Google reckon it's five, and we've got every number, I think, in between and either side. But anyway, David thinks he might have the answer of what that might be. And he goes on then to explain the bank holiday arrangements. Bank holiday arrangements in Spain, which David says produces the answer, really. It gives a description. I'm not too sure about that, David, but you could be right. Philip Pankhurst. After it brings a serious note in, there will be those who doubt whether the heritage railway trains will ever call at Barclay or Sharpness, and will be convinced that the head office stroke dodgy caravan is an indication of just how lost a cause this is. They should be reminded that heritage railway enthusiasts have been performing miracles for generations. This is just another one that just happened to start a bit later. I know just what Philip's referring to there. Our local heritage railway have problems now and again, embankments, slips and all sorts of things. They have to raise vast amounts of cash, and they do it. They get the money coming in. It's absolutely amazing. I think we're talking millions here. Staggering, really, what the British people think of heritage railways, I guess. Wonderful. Michael from Poland again. Greetings from Poland. That was a very interesting walk, and I'm sure Andrew will give us chapter and verse on what we looked at, and of course Andrew did. Thank you, Tony, for all the information about the current use of the site at Barclay. You've become a hero, Tony, well done. He says, the Parkinson's Walks family always come up with loads of interesting information and facts, don't they just? Well done, the Parkinson's family, well done. He said, I hope you're not radioactive. Yeah, you and me both. Simon, last comment this week then, the hairy golfer, once again. I don't know if I have mentioned this before or not. I'm getting old. I don't hear anybody arguing with that statement, Simon. But my dad worked with nuclear waste containers. He was part of the building and test team. They did a lot of testing with 3/4 size models, but this just wasn't enough to satisfy some people. That's when they set up the locomotive crash at 100 miles an hour straight into the lid. My dad was second in command on the crash site. Wow. And again, Simon fills out a little bit more detail for you to peruse. My gosh, wow. You'll have seen the film, no doubt. There's plenty of it on YouTube. Brilliant. Okay. Something that people don't mention, and I did just mention it to Simon, is I wonder what the sound was like. It must have been a hell of a bang. Did they have ear defenders in those days? I don't think I remember seeing any. Oh well. Okay. Right, film club this week, apple tree removal. Excuse me. When we moved in here, we had an apple tree in the corner that stood there unloved, absolutely smothered in ivy, was producing very large fruits which fell at random. There's a bit of a hard hat area down there during the autumn. But we decided that it had to go. I went and looked at it once or twice, and you couldn't even get into it for the blooming ivy everywhere, with bugs and spiders and rot and God knows what. That's a job for the professionals. So they came along and did the job for us, and I filmed it while they were doing it. We left it a stump in the garden. We hoped the birds would be able to make use of. It's since been modified, but there you go. And the old tree's still going. Anyway, here you can admire the skill of these people as they swing around in a tree in a dirty, grotty, horrible job. Lick! Hope you'll enjoy that one. And then next week we're down into the Forest of Dean. Might cheer Trevor up. Trevor likes the Forest of Dean. So we're off down there. Looking for a station. It's even got a name board, this station, so we should better find it, provided we can find the site. And we're going to see if we can dig out anything there we're seeing. I'm, As I'm talking to you, I'm watching a spider crawling around the edge of the lens there on the camera. If he gets in the way, there's going to be trouble. There he goes. Get out of it. Anyway, I'll see you down at Drybrook next Friday. Don't be late.